From Psalm 103, we read, "Praise the Lord, my soul, all my inmost being, praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfies your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord is compassionate and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in love. He will not always accuse, nor will he harbor his anger forever. He does not treat us as our sins deserve, or repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. For he knows how we are formed. He remembers that we are dust. The life of mortals is like grass. They flourish like a flower of the field. The wind blows over it, and it is gone, and its place remembers it no more. But from everlasting to everlasting, the Lord's love is with those who fear him, and his righteousness with their children's children. Praise the Lord, you his angels, you mighty ones who do his bidding, who obey his word. Praise the Lord, all his heavenly hosts. Praise the Lord, all his works everywhere in his dominion. Praise the Lord, my soul."
Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is great.
Let us pray. Dear God, our Father in heaven, we praise and thank you for truly you are good. Your love endures forever. Day after day, you cover us with your protection, and moment by moment, you shower us with your loving kindness. We bless your holy name. Listen to our individual prayers as we name our blessings one by one, in thanksgiving to you, and confess our sins. Thank you, Lord, for forgiving us our sins, for your great indescribable gift of salvation, so rich and free. Abide with us in this worship. Give us spiritual understanding of your word. Unite us in faith and peace. Be pleased with all that we are offering you, our hearts and minds, talents and treasures. Gracious God, continue to transform us more and more to reflect the grace and goodness of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ, in whose wonderful name we pray. Amen. Our scripture reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Many Christians ask, what is God's will for me? Hoping to get an answer that would point them to a goal to attain or a destiny to be reached. 1 Thessalonians 5:18, we discover a clear and practical, plain statement of what God's will is. An open command to live by. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you. In Tagalog, ano ang kalooban ng Diyos para sa inyo, sa inyong pakikipagkaisa kay Kristo Jesus, sa sa pang-araw-araw na buhay. Ang sabi sa 1 Thessalonians 5:18, magpasalamat kayo sa Diyos sa lahat ng pagkakataon. The Old and New Testaments, in so many occasions, teach and command thankfulness. Giving thanks is a principle or primary principle of faith. It is an attitude that Christians continually learn to develop as part of the transforming process of the Holy Spirit, a renewing of the mind. Christian author Johnny Erickson Tada, who became a quadriplegic at the age of 26 after an accident left her paralyzed from the shoulder down, battled anger, depression, suicidal thoughts, and religious doubts during her two years of rehabilitation. And she has this to say: giving thanks is not a matter of feeling thankful. It is a matter of obedience. Why give thanks in all circumstances? That is, whether in pleasure or in pain, in sickness and in health, in victory and in defeat, in good and bad times. Here are some of the reasons why. First, we give thanks to God for He is Creator and provides what we need to survive and live. We know that God made the world in such a way as to sustain life. The sun's light and energy, the oxygen and other elements in the atmosphere to supply our bodies with just the right amount and combination of these elements, the plants and the animals, and water for food and healing, every raw material used for clothing and shelter, and much more. Psalm 100 verses 3 to 4 says, "Know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. Enter into His gates with thanksgiving, and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name." From birth, all throughout our lives, God's natural provisions are there for all people to partake of. So much so that some people, and sometimes we, forget how great a provider God is. As Christians, we are taught to say a prayer of thanksgiving before every meal. And that simple act that we have learned since childhood is meant to keep us mindful of the fact that we are dependent on God for even the most basic of our needs and pleasures, such as food. Second, we give thanks to God for strength and healing. God has created and endowed living creatures with a natural mechanism to heal themselves or receive healing. Psalm 103 verses 1 to 2 says, "Bless the Lord my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who heals all your diseases." He gives the people the ability to be productive as well. Deuteronomy 8:18 says, "Remember the Lord your God, for it is He who gives you the ability to produce wealth. It is He who gives each person the strength and ability to produce something, by brain or brawn, to produce wealth, to develop and increase in productivity. If it were not for God's healing, power and law that have been placed in our bodies and that He continues to supply us with every day of our lives, then we would not have healed from even the slightest of our diseases since we were infants and all the way up to now. Third, we thank God for His grace that saved us from the judgment that our sins deserve, and for His kindness in giving us undeserved eternal life. Ephesians 2, verses 2 to 7 says, "As for you," meaning all of us, "you were dead in your transgressions and sins, in which you used to live when you followed the ways of this world. Like the rest, we were by nature deserving of wrath. But because of His great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive in Christ, even when we were dead in transgressions. It is by grace you have been saved. And God raised us up with Christ and seated us with Him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus, in order that in the coming ages He might show the incomparable riches of His grace expressed in His kindness to us in Christ Jesus." The gift of salvation by faith in Jesus Christ is the greatest gift that surpasses all others in this world and in the next. People may give us all the material things that this world can give, but only God can give the gift of salvation by Christ's death on the cross. That is why Jesus said in Matthew 16, verse 8, "What good will it be for someone to gain or to be given the whole world, yet lose their soul or perish in sin?" That is why, even through physical suffering, the Bible says we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. We do believe in the glory of eternal life that far exceeds any joy and beauty of this earthly life. And we look forward to that life because of Jesus Christ. Fourth, we thank God for the Holy Spirit, who gives us the ability to be overcomers. Ephesians 1:13b says, "When you believed, you were marked in Him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit." And in verses 18 to 20, it goes on to say, "I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened, in order that you may know the hope to which He has called you, His incomparably great power for us who believe." That power is the same as the mighty strength He exerted when He raised Christ from the dead and seated Him at His right hand in the heavenly realms, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in this present age, but also in the one to come. In other words, the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to live in us, is His power working in us to enable us to overcome every trouble, temptation, and trial. 1 John 4:4 says, "The one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world." The one who is in us, the Holy Spirit, the spirit who is in the world, is any other spirit that is not from God. And God's word assures us that the Holy Spirit who is in us is more powerful than any of the spirits that are in the world, because the Holy Spirit is from God, who exerts supreme power. Therefore, we can overcome if we trust God's power and live according to the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Think of the times when you were tempted to disobey God, to give in to the lure of money, to lie, to be unforgiving, to be greedy, to take revenge, to be dishonest, to lose your temper, to be lazy, to think ill of others, to use bad speech. But you were restrained by the Holy Spirit. Those are the times that you aligned yourself to the power of the Holy Spirit and allowed Him to take control of your actions. Think of the times when you were able to endure the pain of physical suffering, of emotional stress, of discouragement, and even of hopelessness. Think of those times. Because you set your mind on the promises of God. You were able to overcome because you put your faith in His love. Those are evidences of the Holy Spirit's power working in you. So for all these and more, we thank God because truly He is good. His love endures forever. He keeps blessing us not only in this life, but He has made a way for us to enjoy eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. What then can we say? In times when we lack the usual provisions, when we lack health and are weak or sick, when we lack funds and need to tighten our belts, or sometimes even seek the help of others, when we lack the support of friends, and we seem to have been left to our own devices, when we lack wisdom and are desperate for solutions to our problems. Philippians 4 verses 12 to 13 reminds us, I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all things through Him who gives me strength. In this life, we will not always have everything in plenty. Jesus said, in this world, you will have trouble. But a maturing Christian will be able to surmount every difficulty. He can do all things, can endure all things, can be patient in all things through the Holy Spirit of Christ who strengthens him. There is one more thing we can thank God for. We can give thanks to God for the privilege of prayer and the power of His Word. Hebrews 4:16 says, let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. God's arms are always open to receive us and our prayers for help. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 reads, His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of Him who called us by His own glory and goodness. God's Word in Scriptures teaches us and makes us know Him and His promises so that we may be able to decide on what is good and pleasing to Him. Jeremiah 29:13 says, you will seek me and find me when you search me with all your heart. I will be found by you, declares the Lord. Knowing this, how should we give thanks to God? The Bible teaches us to praise Him, to let Him know how thankful we are for His goodness and grace. Praise Him in prayer and worship. Think about His love in our minds, to meditate upon Him, trust with grace and confidence, to encourage others, to share our blessings with others, especially with those in most need. These are the ways that we can express our thanksgiving to God. Hebrews 13:16 says, "And do not forget to do good and to share with others, for with such sacrifices God is pleased." Share and support those who are pursuing the ministry and mission of the Lord Jesus Christ, for they are the channels of God's spiritual blessings to you. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I believe you are seeking to do God's will today. I believe that you want to please Him. Therefore, begin with what you have learned from His Word. Give thanks to God and bless His name. He has given us everything and every reason to be grateful, to rejoice, to submit to His will. Let fear go. Let anger and bitterness go. Let discouragement go. Let sadness go. Let doubt go. Let discontentment go. Let arrogance go. Let greed and stinginess go. Because God is good and has been good. Because God loves us. Because He has been good. Because it is God's will for us to take joy in all the gifts that He has given all of us. Above all, let us give thanks to God for the indescribable gift of salvation and peace in Jesus Christ. It is the only way we may enjoy His presence for all eternity. And that gift deserves our thanksgiving every day of our lives. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord. Thank you indeed for blessing us with so much in this life and in the life to come. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness despite our wickedness at times. Thank you, Lord, for your eternal salvation that is promised even while we are here. Thank you, Father, for all your wonderful works, the marvelous things that you have enabled us to do through your church, through the people that you have sent our way. Thank you, Father, for teaching us to develop by your grace this virtue of thankfulness, because you have given us so much more than we can ever thank you for the rest of our lives. We pray, O Lord, that you will indeed make us see the value of your gifts and help us glorify you through our thanksgiving and praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
beauty of a shore, of the day and of the night, even green and green, green tree and flower,
sun, moon, and stars of light,
sun, and moon, and stars of light,
Lord of all today.
Let us pray. Most gracious and loving Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord, we praise you, we exalt your name, for indeed you are good, your love endures forever. We come before you, Lord, humbly but with confidence, because that is what you have commanded us, to enter into your throne, or to come before your throne of grace and mercy, where we can find help for our troubles. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness towards us. We know that you are listening to our prayers, and that your answers are certainly much more than we can even imagine. They are always for our good. We praise you, Lord. We come before you, Lord, to bring our concerns as well as our victories, because we know that without you we cannot do anything. Father, we thank you for all the prayers that you have answered. Thank you, Lord, for all the healing that you have done upon our sick friends and relatives. Thank you, O Lord, for the problems that we have solved. Thank you for the opportunities that you have opened up for us. Thank you, Lord, for giving us an opportunity to earn and to resume our livelihood, especially those who have been adversely affected by this pandemic. We thank you, Father, for preserving us up to this day. Indeed, it is amazing how your love has sustained us, how your provisions have been enough. Lord, we also want to thank you for all the ways that you have saved us from all our troubles. Thank you, Lord, for the ways that you have found for us so that we may be given grace and the opportunity to do what is right once again. Father, we ask that you also be with those who are suffering from grief because of the loss of their loved ones. We pray, Lord, for your comfort, your peace that passes all understanding. We pray, Lord, for those who are still in the bed of sickness, especially those who are troubled because of their fear for their lives and the fear of the expenses and all the other stresses that their weaknesses, their sicknesses may expose their families to. We pray, Lord, that you will heal them. We pray, O God, that you will provide for every need. And we pray that they will never forget to thank you even in the midst of trouble. We know that your help is always sufficient. Your help is always present. Lord, we also want to lift up to you our respective families, that you will be able to accomplish your will through our obedience. Help us, Lord, to always do what is right, even when it is not easy. Lord, as you continue to transform our minds to be thankful in all circumstances, we also ask, O God, that you transform our minds so that we will be able to stand by your truth and righteousness despite the many challenges around us, despite the lies that continue to circulate, despite the temptations to just flow with the tide. Father, we pray that you will protect us from the wiles of the evil one and that we will be wise to discern what is right and wrong and to always choose what is right and good in your sight. Help us as a church to continue to be a beacon of light, the light of truth, the light of righteousness, the light of goodness. We pray, Father, that indeed we will be your true ambassadors, reflecting your will, your ways, your goodness. Lord, we lift up to you the troubles that are going on in many nations around us. Those who are plotting evil against one another, and those who are victims of oppression and all kinds of wickedness. We pray, Lord, that you will silence the enemy and that you will disarm him in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray, Lord, that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that you are Lord through the proclamation of your gospel. We pray, Lord, that as a church, as we continue to disciple one another, you may use us to spread your word, not only through what we preach, but also by the way we conduct our lives. Father, we pray for the unrest that is now prevailing in many countries of the world, in the Middle East, here in our very own region of Asia, as well as Europe. There is so much trouble around us, O God. And though we are fearful and sometimes troubled by all of these developments, help us to always remember that you are sovereign and you are in control, and that your truth, your justice, and peace will prevail in the end. Father, we continue to lift up to you our beloved nation as we go through the many challenges of our times. We pray, Lord, that the Christians among those who are in the positions of leadership, both in public and private service, will rise up to their calling. O Lord, we pray that they will be influencers for the good and not for compromise. We also pray, O God, that your hand, your miraculous hand, will be upon our nation and that you will save us, O God, from all the troubles, Lord, that have been caused by our very own neglect and disobedience. Father, we pray that the church will arise and be your voice of truth, your voice of goodness, your voice of peace in these troubled times. Thank you so much, O Lord, for everything that you have made, everything, Lord, that you have worked out, even in the midst of our weaknesses, because they are always for our good, for the good of the people who love you and are called according to your purpose. Lord, listen to the prayers of each one now who is here with us. Please have mercy upon them, O God, and grant them their desires according to your will, your perfect will. Thank you, O God. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Brothers and sisters in Christ, God is good. His love endures forever. May the love of God the Father, the grace of Jesus Christ our Lord, and the empowerment of the Holy Spirit be yours now and always. Amen. A blessed day, everyone. Thank you for joining us once again in our worship this day. Indeed, this is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We continue to observe Thanksgiving month, this month of November, and we praise God indeed for all His marvelous works in our midst. And so we would like to let you know that next Sunday we will be celebrating our traditional annual Everybody's Birthday. So to prepare for that, let us be in an attitude of thanksgiving and think about the things that God has done and God has been to us the entire year, and be ready to list them down and present them to the Lord in prayer next Sunday. This afternoon is Youth Link at 3 o'clock, and please join the youth in Google Meet for their third Sunday worship. For those of you who wish to join the Tagalog service of our Cosmopolitan Church Il Giardino Satellite Congregation, please know that another service has been uploaded in their YouTube channel, Cosmopolitan Church Il Giardino. And next Sunday is already our annual congregational meeting and election of officers, as announced last week through our FB page and our LOA page. Please prepare for that. We will be using the platform of Zoom, so that we can all be together and thank God for all the things that He has accomplished through our church this past year. And the procedure for our election of officers will be done also electronically. And all the details will be given to you as well through our FB page. The election of officers will proceed as usual, as we have done last year, and we would like to thank God for all those who have accepted the call to serve and be candidates for this year's election, from the council officers all the way to the different members of the boards, the five boards. And at this time, we would like to say a special prayer for the candidates as we approach Election Day. For the list of all the candidates, please refer to our FB private group page as well as our LOA page. Let us now pray for our candidates. Almighty God, our Father in heaven, we lift up to you these your children, our brothers and sisters in Christ, who have accepted the call to be candidates to the various positions of leadership in the church and to serve starting next year. We praise you, Lord, for raising men and women who are qualified, who have the heart for service, and who have a love for your church to help build her up and to be able to unite together in the service of your people. We ask, O God, that even as we are preparing for the elections, you will also prepare their hearts and their minds and their spirits to have that spirit of servanthood, just like our Lord and Savior, the head of this church, Jesus Christ, who came not to be served, but to serve and to offer his life as a ransom for many. We pray, Father, that you will give these candidates the confidence to serve you because they know that you will be always with them and will help them through the many challenges as well as the opportunities for service. Thank you, Lord. And we pray that each one of them will already rise up in their commitment and praise you, Lord, for the opportunity to serve. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Finally, we would like to greet our birthday and anniversary celebrants this week. Happy birthday, Mary Del Custodio, Loris Ann Dominguez, Luminarda Delgado, Rowena Diamante, Nenita Dondriano, Isaiah Daniel Mendoza, Resurrection Reyes, Kulani Nasayaw, Marlene Pacursa, Joel Plaza, and Renative Rose Malolos. And happy wedding anniversary to Aludio and Rebecca Talabok and Alex and Beth Canson. Let us pray. Our gracious and loving Father in heaven, we thank you and we praise you, Lord, for our brothers and sisters in Christ who are celebrating milestones. We thank you, Lord, for the gift of life and most especially the gift of eternal life in Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for those who are celebrating their birthdays. May they continue to mark their days not only by the years that have been added to their lives, but to the life that have been added to their years. We pray, Lord, that they will continue to mature in their faith, in their knowledge of you, and in their love for you. We also pray, O God, that you will listen to the deepest desires of their hearts and align them with your will. We pray, Father, that you will provide for all of their needs and that you will grant them the desires of your hearts as they delight in you. Father, we also would like to lift up to you our wedding anniversary couples. We praise you, Lord, for the gift of love that you have given them to share with one another and with their family. We continue to pray that you will strengthen them, not only in body, mind, and spirit, but strengthen the bond of love between them. We pray, Lord, that they will continue to be together and serve you with all their heart, soul, mind, and strength. Lord, please help them in times of trouble. Help them, Lord, in times of major decisions, that they may truly honor one another and above all, honor you. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Goodbye, everyone, and have a blessed week ahead. Thank you for joining us. God bless you.